Welcome back. Well, today's project, we're going to tune up this 1946 Dodge Power Wagon. And if you're not familiar with a Power Wagon, it might not mean that much to you. Might not be that interested, but it's a flathead six-cylinder, pretty common. Points condenser, cap rotor. And I'm going to give it a big treat and throw spark plugs in it too. So, but we got a flat tire. They just don't hold up like they used to, you know. This one is, I don't know. How many years old? The tread's starting to fall off. Can't believe it. So we'll throw a little air in that. Raise this truck back up to where it should be. And then we'll go from there. We'll pop the hood and get the points condenser in there. Get them set, see how we make out. Just for comparison, 1946. And over there's a 2021. Not a Dodge, but pretty close. It's a Ford F-150. I was going to buy the anniversary edition Dodge Power Wagon to say I had one in the first year and one 75 years later. But checking the gas mileage and the height of it and the off-road capabilities, I'm not into that kind of stuff. So I opted to go with a Ford. And I'm very happy with it. So I'm going to pause it here and we'll get some air in that tire. And get this baby tuned up. Okay, we're back. And the hood is up. So, let's get our cap off here, which I'm hoping I got the right parts. Kind of hit and miss when you come order parts for these old things. Yeah, rotor looks good. Cap looks like new. But we're going to put new ones in. So, let me get a couple screwdrivers here and we'll come back and get them points condenser out of there. I have a feeling if I just reset the points and clean them up, it'll probably be okay. But, you know, every 15 years or so you ought to treat your old truck. Got a little music on. It's been a while since I've done this. I think the last time I did it, I didn't need glasses. Anyway, I think I took the whole assembly right out of the cap, if I remember right. There's a screw over here, screw over there, if you can see that. That holds like a tray that holds the condenser and points. So I'm going to need a different screwdriver. I'll pause this and come back again. Hard to get me down there with a camera, but this goes on the side of the distributor and then a little screw in it there. And then this flips up and grabs your distributor cap. I got one off because the filler pipe for the crankcase is right there. I had a stubby screwdriver. I gotta see if I can get the other one off. I have to work out a little bit, so I'll pause it again. But then I can take the whole apparatus out that holds the points, get everything bolted back in, so bear with me. Okay. Yeah, there's a screw over on this side, screw on this side. So now, take the screws out that hold the points in where the points are held in. Actually, this whole thing might come out now. Yeah. And then that allows me to get, well, this guy, we could take a screw out anyway. I think I'll leave it in. Let's see if we can get this whole assembly out here. Come on. There we go. Then I can get at this screw, because that holds the condenser wire on. So once I get that off, okay. And then that releases the wire from the coil. And there's our tray. So we'll put the new points condenser back on there. Slip that back in place, get the condenser wire back on, and the wire from the coil needs to go back on there. And now once I get that all mounted up, I'll show you what it looks like when I come back. Yeah, change plans. I'll show you what it looks like here, right on the workbench. Spark plugs. Funny thing, you gotta buy 8 plugs, you can't buy 6. Online anyway. Sold multiples of 4. So, I have 2 extra, or we'll put them in a log splitter. Very similar to a J8. But that's how things were back in the day, you know, a spark plug for your vehicle, and same plugs fit your log splitter. There's the points. Pretty tough to look stuff up on the internet. I had the old standard ignition numbers. And condenser's not a big deal. That's pretty standard ignition. I mean, condenser's a condenser. Take care of that. Points are the big thing. Let's see what we have here. I'm kind of worried about that. I kind of remember what they look like by eye, and everything looks good. So, get it mounted on here. You'll see, might as well explain it now. You put the points in this screw here. It's kind of eccentric screw, and that's how you adjust the gap on your points. Just wraps around here, goes along with the coil and the condenser. Okay, enough of dinosaur. Hey, Echo. Echo. Play the 60s on 6. 60s gold from Sirius XM. Now you're talking. Get our corn denser on here. Nice. Wraps around the wire. Wire might be a little too long. So, what are we going to do with that? Maybe we can come back around and go on, huh? Bunch it up there a little bit. I can put it on the back side here. We can get the lay in here. Yeah, that'll be good. Tighten that up. Slug that up a little better. There you have it. Points will break. Gotta put our mounting screw back in the points. Yeah. Bear with me because I dropped stuff a couple times. I don't have the smallest fingers either.
Elvis Presley, his version of Suspicious Minds, as Sirius XM 60's Gold. I always like Morgan Wade's brand new version that she has done of that song. You ever hear it? Oh my gosh, here's a clip of it. Yeah, this is the brand new one. Here we go. Yeah, and then it mixes in. And then it sounds like an Electric Light Orchestra moment once it gets into it. Really an amazing
Come on.
Version of Morgan Wade doing the song Suspicious Minds. You're at the Flashful Funny Farm at 60s Gold. Oh, hi. Wait, listen, who is that that's listening? It's Ralph? Yeah, how do you say your last name? Irio? I hope that's right. New Bern, North Carolina, the home of all the painted bears. I always love going to your town, New Bern, North Carolina. I just stopped in about a month ago. And I understand you just had a knee transplant. Michelle told us that and says you listen after 10:30.
And this will just make snug.
We want you to get better after the knee transplant.
Show you here when you turn this screw.
Sirius XM 60's Gold.
Changes your, that's how you set your gap. Once you have your gap set right, because the cam here is going to, this plastic's going to ride on the cam, make the points break. So, I'll pause it here, see if we can get it back in place, and see if we can get this truck to start a little better. Kind of don't like that there, but yeah, it is what it is. It'll be fine. Okay, I'll pause it here, and we'll be back when we get it mounted back in there. By the way, these old points, you'll be able to see it on there, but contacts were pretty well. I only have a phone here, so. I'd say I got the life out of them. They're pretty well cooked up. So. I got it back in place, and I have the screw in down here for this clip. It holds the clip for the distributor cap, and it also holds that tray in. Okay, let's see if we can get this one on. Man, if only I had better light.
So here's what's going on. John has his birthday today. That'll be John Calcill. But he's with the Beach Boys. And so they're taking the day off for his birthday. And then they'll play Fort Lauderdale tomorrow. So if you're in Fort Lauderdale to see the Beach Boys, you can yell happy birthday.
I think.
That'd be really cool. And also Al Jardine family and friends, they're doing their show in Bethesda tonight. So they have that tour that is on. Hey, I just heard from a friend, Bob, down in Florida. He was in Wyoming for a while. And here's what he just told me. He said, hey, guess what I'm going to do this summer? So Yellowstone National Park. So he went over to West Yellowstone and was there and just be right there at the park. And Yellowstone is celebrating 150th anniversary yesterday from 1872. So Bob said, I'm going to go up to North Rock in the Lincoln area of New Hampshire.
Loosen this one up.
Trading post. So I wrote back. I said, well, you know,
so close to being.
I said, well, you always hear me talking to Morgan over at Morgan's Diner. That's Morgan Clark or Ashley Clark. I've had her on. I've had Elise Clark.
I think we got it.
Yep-er. You're going to get to know how popular 16 Gold is.
You can see how tight things are in here.
All right. I'll be up there to see you this summer. 60s Gold.
We'll get her pretty close here, and then we'll get our clip around where it needs to be. Comes up and grabs the cap. Yeah, it looks pretty straight. Let's snug her back up here if I can find a slot again. Yeah, I found it, but it twisted his clip. See, they give you a little play in there, so. Oh. Okay. Time to set our gap. Kind of lost the picture there for a little while. These little clips here. Comes around, grabs the top of the cap, or the side of the distributor cap. One on each side, of course. So let me pause it here, get my feeler gauges, and then we'll get on one of the high spots of our what do you call it, distributor cam, you know, the thing that breaks the points. If you don't know about points condenser, it won't mean anything to you, but trying to get on a high spot, and that's where you set your gap. So I'll be right back. Okay, we got on a high spot there. And like I said before, when you adjust this screw up here, pretty tough to see on here. I need light to see what I'm doing, but then it's too much light for the camera. But there's a screw right here that'll adjust your gap. And I forget, it's probably been 10 or 15 years since I did this, but I think the gap is around 19, so. We'll try that. Way too wide. Let's tighten her up a little bit. Still too wide. Down a little further. Kind of got to sneak up on it. Let's try that. Well, I can tell you that's too tight because I can't get a feeler gauge in. Try and see if we can do it with two hands here. Getting close. And of course, the ultimate test is if the truck won't start, you don't have it set right. Too tight, and the two hands not going to work. Let's loosen her up here a little bit.
Where did Mardi Gras get its start? All down in Mobile, Alabama.
That's not bad. And the next thing is when you tighten the screw up to hold it in place, sometimes they move just a little bit. And that'll give you trouble.
Over in Oregon, and she said she grew up in Las Vegas, and she's now one of the caregivers for seniors. Fantastic. Thank you, Vera.
Yeah, see, that's...
John Souza has written in. 45 years
a little too tight. So we'll loosen this just a little bit.
And he said, I grew up in the Boston area listening to WMEX.
And
fantastic. Great station. Let's see, we have the Iditarod that is going to be on at
Alaska
on Saturday. And they've had a lot of snow, so they should be ready to go getting that back underway. Sirius XM 60 is cold. You know where it should be warm?
Little trial and error here.
In the middle of the U.S. 73 today, Denver, 80 Kansas City. Enjoy it, and then that's going to move east. Even places like Buffalo.
Not too loose yet.
By
a little bit more.
You're at Sirius XM 60 Gold.
A little bit more. Be a little too loose yet. Too tight. Just a little too loose, but like I said, when you tighten up the screw to set them in place, it tends to draw it down a little bit. Wow, I think we got it there. Yeah, it might be a little too loose yet. So we'll keep forging ahead here. That's pretty close. We'll know here in about 10 minutes. So put our cap back on here. We do have a new cap, but show you how these clips come back up. One on that side. Get this one over here. Okay. Now what we're going to do, change our spark plugs. The first thing I do before I change them, since this sits outside amongst the varmints and squirrels and whatever other creepy crawler things get in there, they like to make drop seeds and make a mess, and you know. So I took the wires off the first two, but I'm going to stop there. We'll blow these out. By the way, that set of horns is not stock. They were a pair of horns that come off a 56 Chrysler Imperial. So keep it all Mopar. Anyway, we'll get the plugs changed. No sense wasting time with that. Be right back. Okay, we got the plugs in. And the way I do it, I take the old distributor cap off here. I just put that back on while I blew out the holes for the other, for the spark plugs there. Kind of set it off to the side there. Compare our rotor, make sure we got the right one. New. Old one. Looks like a winner. Wasn't really bad, but you know, if you're gonna go through this, and might as well treat the old girl right. New distributor cap. Let's go this way. Oh, look at that. I was a little concerned about that because the old numbers I had were standard ignition. There we go. Where'd that one come from? Ruh-roh. Right there. Okay. And we'll just work our way around. I mean, if I knew the firing order, wouldn't be that big of an issue. And if I didn't know the firing order, I'm sure I could call an auto parts store and find it. Yeah, that's funny. Let's see here. That didn't feel too good. That looks good. And this one goes on the other side of the clip. And this one must go on the last one, huh? Okay, let me get rid of some of this stuff out of the way. Forget anything? Looks good. I'll take you around and show you our gas tank. Needs a little body work. A little bit. About 20 years ago, the original gas tank got a little leak in it, and I couldn't get it stopped. And since it was off the road, I thought, I'm not pulling the tank down and all that stuff. Get it brazed up or try to buy a new tank for an old Power Wagon. Might be one out there somewhere. So I thought the best thing to do would be put this 5-gallon gas can on the passenger side of the floor. And it is a really good spot because this here's the plow pump run with like a Ford motor, old Ford type starter motor, and it runs the pump, and I have power angle, and it's just out of the way far enough so that it's not too close to the gas tank because it sparks once in a while, you know, so we have quick exit. So we'll get the gas tank out and hook our fuel line back up. Yeah. I think we're good to go. But it's lunchtime, so I got a break for lunch. Be right back. Might as well show you the other side of the engine here. I'm not sure, but I think this is early enough. I think there was a 230 cubic inch. I think this is less than that. I'm not sure. Might be some Dodge experts out there that could tell you, but no air filter, but I don't run it in the summer anyway, so it's only in the winter. Got a little ventilation here, and the headlights fell off. Just give a quick overview. I acquired this truck back in 1982, 83. This one might have been 83. My first one was 1982. I bought a Power Wagon. It was along the road with a plow on it. The plow wasn't mounted really correctly, and it had the original pickup bed box on it. And I needed something at the time to plow a driveway where I was renting, and I bought it for $1,500. Had that a couple years, never put it on the road. And then a year or two later, I had an uncle that was a diehard Mopar man, Dodge, and he loved Power Wagons. And he found out I had one, and he said, he knew where there was another one, which would be this one, with a dump box. He bought it. I don't think he paid much for it. But it had a broken axle and some other things, that the motor was no good. And he said, how about we make one out of the two? You pay for the parts and things and I'll help you. He's a very generous guy. Best mechanic you'll ever find. I won't mention his name, but he was a good mechanic, a good man, very generous. And we worked quite a bit to get one truck from the two of them. Dump box still works. It's getting pretty rotted up. It looked really good 40 years ago. They weren't made to run over the road with the salt. The fenders caught all the salt. You can tell it just laid up in there and it just rotted them out. It's slow. I had it about 2 years. And I was pulling trees with it in the back in the woods, and I broke a tooth off the ring gear. And when you went down the road, it would skip. So back to my uncle, and he said, well, let's figure out if it's the front or the rear. Found out it was the one in the rear, naturally. pulled the differentials out, and of course I had the original truck. When I pulled the differentials out of this one, and by the way, the front and the rear differential are the same, interchangeable. He said, hopefully their gear ratio is the same, which it wasn't. What was in it, I believe, were 586 or 583 to 1. So if that means anything to some of you enthusiasts out there, that's geared for some low speed and high power. Pulled the ones out of the other truck. The first truck that I bought, they were 489 to 1. So I was able to go downhill maybe 50 or 55 instead of 45 now. 49 to 1, that's what's in it now. I did put lockout hubs on it. I bought them from Vintage Power Wagons. Not sure if he's still in business out in Iowa. And that way you weren't turning all that stuff up there. You know, just had caps on it before where everything was rotating all the time. So anyway, I delivered a lot of firewood in this thing. Plowed snow with it. I still use it today. It's pretty bad shape, but I just can't part with it. I've had it so long. So if we spend $70 for tune-up on it, we'll keep her going as long as we can. Like I said, this year I didn't need it to plow snow. We didn't get a lot of snow. And I have a tractor, a Kubota L4060 with a rear blade, handles most of the snow, but, and winter's not over yet. So if we get like a foot or a foot and a half freak storm, then I press this into service and away we go. But it's been having a little trouble starting lately to move it around. That's why I thought I'd do a tune-up. So we got gas in our can in the cab there, and we're going to try the first start here. Sometimes the points can be finicky. I think I have them set correctly, but I'll pause it here, go around the other side, see if we can get her started up. Okay, we're back. Let's see what she sounds like here, see if we can get her fired up. Bear with me. Okay. Okay, we're going to try it one more time. I adjusted the points a little bit. Like I said, I'm not sure what the gap is. It's either 17 or 19. I ended up loosening them a little bit. I don't know. Let's give it a shot. Like I said, a little trial and error. Always worked for me before. Okay. Here we go. that thing purr. Gas in the gas tank. Let's check, see how much we're charging. Hang on. Well, we're charging. We'll fill the antifreeze up because that leaks. And we'll fill the oil up because so back 1990 or so, rebuilt the engine. Already bored out 30 over, so we went 60 over. But yours truly put the main seal in, and it was one of those felt seals. Obviously, I didn't know what I was doing, and it's leaked a little oil ever since. But that way, we don't have to change it, just keep putting new in. We'll back out of the garage here and give you a better view. I guess, gotta start it one more time. Partial antifreeze, might as well dump that in. I know it'll take it. Oh, I can see some. There you go. Always amazed me how big this radiator is for a little six-cylinder engine. Here we go. Again. Thank you. There she is. What a beauty. Got that in Spring, Texas, 1993. Gonna wrap it up there. Thanks for watching.